remember the widespread news and social media coverage about Tesla's lining up at EV chargers during the Chicago cold snap in mid-January? And what about North American EV sales in 2023 and possibly 2024 falling off a cliff? While there are some challenges surrounding EVs, such as the need to build out US charging infrastructure, automakers are on track to continue on a path of substantial growth. Leading analysts agree that sales and market share will continue to grow in 2024, but they disagree on the rate of growth and give different weights to some of the main factors that affect the market, from gasoline prices to the availability of low-cost car models. Pessimism about the EV market gained momentum in 2023 when Ford and General Motors said that demand for their vehicles was falling short of expectations and pared back aspects of their EV plans. We covered the change in plans by both automakers in our previous videos. Check out the links in the description below for more on that. At the same time, Tesla warned investors of enormous challenges related to the production and rollout of Cybertruck. Cybertruck, according to Tesla, is designed for the outdoor adventure enthusiasts. And if that isn't enough to convince EV skeptics, Cybertruck's $81,000 US base price is further proof that the Tesla EV isn't a reflection of the EV market. These problems get amplified by commentary, often politically motivated, that seem to take advantage of every opportunity to say that the energy transition isn't realistic. Despite the storm clouds surrounding EVs, sales in 2023 were quite strong. US consumers purchased nearly 1.2 million all-electric vehicles, up 46% from the previous year, according to Cox Automotive. EVs had a 7.6% share of overall car and light truck sales, and that was up 5.9% over the previous year. And in 2023, EV sales reached 1 million units for the first time. Every automaker in the top 10 of EV sales showed a minimum 10% year-over-year increase in EV sales from 2022 to 2023, with some automakers nearly tripling their sales. BMW and Mercedes-Benz would be two examples. Looking at forecasts from major auto industry analysts, 2024 sales of EVs are expected to increase a minimum of 20% year over year versus 2023. So, what's the issue with EVs? It's not that people don't want EVs, it's that people want affordable EVs. And when I say that, I mean EVs that are priced at $35,000 and lower. At the moment, the most affordable EV options are Tesla Model 3 and Model Y and Chevrolet Bolt. The key thing to note with Tesla, however, is the need for federal and in some cases state rebates in order to put them within reach for the average American consumer. There are some affordable options, however, coming to market in 2024. This would be the Volvo EX30 and Chevy Equinox, both of which are compact crossover SUVs. According to Kelley Blue Book, the average starting price for an EV in 2023 was just over 53K. That price, along with high interest rates currently in the US, make car loans a lot less affordable for people. And that's going to drive people to look elsewhere, namely hybrid electric vehicles as an affordable electrified alternative that cuts down on the need to visit the gas pump. But this price point not only affects the decision-making of consumers, it also affects the decision-making of automakers. many automakers invested heavily to rethink their product lines to offer EVs, as well as retool their manufacturing and supply chain operations to support the production of electric vehicles. Several automakers, however, have taken huge losses on making EVs. In reality, the EVs they offered were too expensive for many people, or people simply didn't want them. Mercedes-Benz, with its EQ line of EVs, is an example. For more on that, check out our video in the description link below about the Mercedes-Benz EQ line of vehicles and issues with consumer demand. Analysts predict that 2026 will likely be the crossover point for the availability of low-cost EVs in the US. Some of the models that may be available then could be a lower-cost Tesla and a new version of the Chevrolet Bolt from General Motors. And who knows what we might see from the likes of Ford Motor Company, Volkswagen, and Nissan. It's also important to take into account that gas prices are a key decision-making variable for consumers when they are buying a vehicle. If gas prices spike, it helps EV sales. The lack of EV charging infrastructure is also a major factor that's holding back many consumers from buying an EV. Tesla is the only major automaker of EVs that has succeeded in building a large and reliable charging network with Tesla Supercharger. Beginning this year, several automakers will enable their vehicles to be compatible with Tesla Supercharger. Many more automakers will feature Tesla's NACS charging port on their vehicles beginning in 2025. In 2021, the Biden administration established an EV charging mandate for North America. This mandate was supposed to lead to a surge in deployment of public EV charging stations across the US, but the process of approving projects and getting them built has been slow. Automakers and government programs have been working to accelerate the rollout of EV charging stations across the country. However, election season 2024 in the US is coming, and that could shift momentum away from a broad rollout of EV charging infrastructure in the US. EV affordability and the availability of EV charging infrastructure don't solve all of the challenges surrounding EVs. There's still the consumer perception aspect of how EVs work, specifically as it relates to charging the vehicles. There has been extensive coverage in the news media recently about charging EVs in cold weather, but the negative press around electric vehicles and charging them isn't quite the indictment that the extensive media coverage made it out to be. It turns out that according to a recent Norwegian study, that gas and diesel cars are nearly twice as likely to have trouble starting in extreme weather conditions. That fact, however, wasn't reported by the media. Now, some might doubt the legitimacy of a report coming out of Norway, given that it is a relatively small country. But something very noteworthy about the country is that a quarter of all the vehicles on the road are electric vehicles. Also of note is that the average winter temperature in Norway is about -7 Celsius, or just under 20 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, this is no argument in favor of EVs breaking down in extreme weather. After all, the temperatures during the cold spell in Chicago and other parts of the US and Canada plummeted to -30 Fahrenheit, along with snow conditions. These are dangerously cold temperatures, and obviously a motor vehicle of any type is essential for many people in such conditions, especially when getting to and from can become a matter of life or death. It seems, however, recently that the media, be it traditional news media or social media, and in some cases, some very noteworthy politicians, love to pile on as it relates to the negative aspects of EVs. That's understandable to a point. New technology always has its hiccups, but it's time to separate the myths from the reality and take a look at why sometimes EVs get more negative press than they deserve. We'll break down some of the biggest misconceptions about EVs. That would be cold weather struggles, EVs catching on fire, and the idea that you can't find a place to charge an EV anywhere. Plus, we'll dig into how news coverage itself can be part of the problem regarding the perception of EVs. One of the possibly more misunderstood aspects of EVs is why they lose range in cold weather. Lithium-ion batteries are susceptible to cold weather, and that's due to their chemistry. As the temperatures drop, the capacity of the battery, both in terms of getting charged as well as retaining its charge, decreases significantly. EV batteries function best at a certain temperature, much the way that gas vehicles do. When temperatures are too low, it slows the chemical reactions and reduces the amount of charge that an EV battery holds. And EV software will slow down the charging speed to avoid stressing the battery. But EV makers are working to solve this challenge. One of the world's leading EV battery makers, South Korea-based SK On, is designing a battery that loses significantly less range in the cold and can charge to 80% in just 15 minutes. There are also things that can be done to improve the performance of EV batteries in cold weather. If charging an EV outdoors or publicly, automakers recommend preheating the battery to ensure that when drivers arrive at the EV charger, the temperature of the battery is optimal and ready to charge. This reduces the amount of the time required to charge battery, as well as ensure the reliability of the charging experience. In any situation when dealing with extreme weather, be it gas vehicles or electric vehicles, it's always best to take the proper precautions to ensure that the vehicle will perform optimally and reliably. And what about EV fires? Whenever an EV catches fire, it seems to always be big news. It's true that EV fires are difficult to extinguish. Fire departments, however, have gotten better at using methods and materials to quickly extinguish EV fires. But the negative press around EVs and their fire risk is largely misinformation. In Sweden, a study was conducted where in 2022, 23 fires in EVs were reported out of 611,000 electric vehicles. This is roughly 0.004% in 1 year, which makes it 20 times less likely for a fire to happen in an EV than in a gas car. Gas cars burned 3,400 times out of 4.4 million vehicles. So this makes EV fire risks roughly 5% of that of gas vehicles. If EVs were a frequent fire risk, as they are often made out to be, it would be reflected in an EV's insurance premium, but it isn't. And EVs simply wouldn't be viable for the road if they were a serious fire risk. Then there are reports about the lack of EV charging infrastructure. I mentioned earlier that Tesla has opened up its supercharger network for use by EVs from other automakers. Beyond that, even with a slowdown in EV sales, companies like ChargePoint, which is a leading charging infrastructure provider in the US, is still seeing massive growth in charging station usage. The company is seeing increased use of its roughly 34,000 charging stations and is expected to see that growth continue. The company's view is that businesses will provide the infrastructure. It just takes time to catch up. Any negative incidents involving a motor vehicle, be it gas or electric, is sure to garner attention. The problem with negative press around EVs, however, is misinformation. A recent study of more than 12,000 climate-related YouTube videos posted since 2018 found that climate denial, where people think that global warming is fake, has been replaced by another form of dissent. While outright denial of the existence of climate change has declined by a third, videos discrediting climate solutions like EVs have more than tripled. But it's not simply the algorithms by the major social media platforms that drive the misinformation around EVs. It's also the news coverage that EVs receive. And to be quite candid, it's nothing new. It's just the way journalism works as it relates to what makes news and what doesn't. Going back to the incident about the January Chicago cold snap, that showed Teslas lining up at EV charging stations and they could not charge due to extreme weather. The reality, though, is that most EV drivers charge their vehicles at home. And when I say most, that would be 80% of EV owners. That's something that many media outlets will withhold because it simply isn't newsworthy. Journalism and social media thrive on what will generate attention. Thousands of EVs charging just fine in the affected extreme weather area, not news. But a handful of EVs struggling after a blizzard, that's news. Electric vehicles, of course, aren't perfect, but the misinformation about how well they're selling, how they perform under various conditions, their fire risk, and issues around EV charging and EV charging infrastructure aren't nearly as severe as they are made out to be. EVs are key for reducing CO2 tailpipe emissions, which will reduce pollution and improve air quality. And EVs are improving rapidly. We are, however, only at the beginning of this transition. In the words of hip-hop legends Public Enemy, don't believe the hype around misinformation. For more from the definitive source for clean tech, e-mobility, and sustainability, make sure that you're like and subscribe to cleanearth.io.